Here we go with another video. We've got a switch here which decides that it doesn't like to read cartridges. So if we bang one in, absolutely nothing happens. I think after a minute or so it comes up cannot read the cartridge. So yeah, that slot is completely dead. And the cartridge is in good condition. I know this works because I've tried it on here. Works perfect. There, still nothing. So let's have a look inside the cart slot to see what we can see. Okay, so can you see what I see? We've got some bent pins here. Not entirely sure if there's some missing. Oh, there we go. Yep, that's about to break. So yeah, we need to replace this cartridge slot. So we don't need to go too nuts here. Just need to get the back off and get the cartridge slot out. So it's not a full strip down. Not quite decided yet how I'm going to get the cartridge slot off. I don't know whether to just heat gun it off or use solder wick and go round. Need to remove this ribbon cable for the digitizer, which is incredibly delicate. Just got to take it easy until it folds back. There we go. And then there's the main connector here to the main board. Just lift that up. This should pop straight out. There we have it. There's the cartridge slot. Okay, so we need to remove this from this. Let's just fold that back down. And we've got some new ones here. So we've got four anchor points. Here, here, here and here, which actually go through this very thin PCB. And then we've got a couple more anchor points here, but they're on the top, and then all these pins across here. So what I'm thinking I'll do is I will get the solder out of these anchor points here, so then it's only this edge that will be holding cartridge slot to the PCB, and then I'll just run some hot air off there and hopefully just lift off the port. So let's give it a go. So let's start by adding some lead free solder. Let's just do it to those two there first of all. Seems to have worked quite well. It's cleared out those holes that side. We'll just do these two here. Excellent. Here are the four mounting points. And they all look like they've completely cleared of solder. So I should be able to move it now. There we go, it's that side. And I think this side is gripping on a little bit. It is. Let's see if we can persuade it slightly. Don't think we can. Okay, there we go. So now we just have it basically hinging on all of those pins at the back there. So let's get him mounted back up. There we go, there's the port. Now we'll just use some solder wick, get rid of all that solder. There we have it. A nice new port and do a dry fit. Okay, and that fits perfect. All the pins line up exactly as they should. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to solder these four anchor points so this is nice and flat, and then I'll go under the microscope and we'll do these pins here. Soldered down, the solder has flowed nicely through the board. Now just go for this. Let's get this all soldered up and get it ready for a test. Okay, after messing about with that too much, let's check all these pins are actually soldered. And they are. Just put a blob of solder on that anchor point just to match the other side, otherwise I'll never be able to live with myself. I think we need a bit of luck, especially when it comes to these cartridge slots on switches. Man, can they be a headache. he hasn't got much battery, so let's plug him in. Okay, so let's give it a burl. Shazam, we're in like sin. Should cover up these names here.